Hi everyone, we again welcome you in our classroom. Dear student, today we are going to make an effort to learn the difference between three terminologies of accountancy, that are accountancy itself, bookkeeping and accounting. Here we have mentioned the basis on which we are going to differentiate these three concepts. Here we are having accountancy, bookkeeping and accounting. Very first, in terms of money, accountancy can be defined as a systematic and scientific body of knowledge having principles, concepts, formats and rules to be followed by both, be they are bookkeeper or accountant, while recording, classifying, summarizing, analyzing, interpreting and communicating the results of business transactions performed over the period of time. So here we can say this is the plethora, or this is that book which is having all the norms to be followed by accountants and bookkeeper while performing their jobs. Then we come to the bookkeeping. The first two step or three step in the process of accounting are called bookkeeping, like identifying and analyzing transactions on the basis of their source document, recording them in original books of account called journal and posting them into their classified account called ledger is called bookkeeping. When we talk about accounting, it is a complete process which is followed by an accountant when he analyzes, interprets, then record the transactions, then post them into their respective account and finally summarize them in the form of final account, applies his conscience to analyze and interpret the result and present in that form which becomes convenient and understandable to all the related parties is called accounting. The second base of reference is the scope. That means how many activities are being part of that particular term. When we talk about accountancy, accountancy is a guiding torch for both, be they are bookkeeper or accountant. It means accountancy can be defined as a wider term, a comprehensive term. Bookkeeping and accounting both are part and parcel of it. When we talk about bookkeeping, this is the part of accounting. It means it is a narrower term as compared to the accounting, whereas accounting includes both bookkeeping plus summarization, analysis, interpretation and communication of result or developing different kind of report to be disseminated to all related parties. It means accounting is a broader term, bookkeeping is the narrow term part of accounting, whereas these both are going to be the part of accountancy. Then we talk about stage. Accountancy is a pre-starting stage. You may call it pre-primary stage. It means very first we have to learn about the principles, concepts, formats which are to be applied by us while we will start acting as an accountant or bookkeeper. Very first when we apply such concept what we have learned through accountancy while recording and classifying business transactions is called bookkeeping. It is the primary stage. Accounting is going to be the secondary stage. That means rest of the artistic part is being performed in the accounting. And finally, if we further move ahead, a step more, that will be called auditing. It means accounts are verified by those who are authorized by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, whether they are maintained as per the guidelines of accountancy as well as those accounting standards which are prescribed by in a particular country or the world as a whole by the representative personnel bodies. Then we are coming to relationship. Both of these, that means bookkeeping and accounting, are dependent on the accountancy, whereas bookkeeping is only dependent on the accountancy. Accounting is dependent on both accountancy and bookkeeping. Then we are coming to talk about objectives. The objective of the body of knowledge which provide guidance to the bookkeepers and accountant is to enable them to maintain systematic and scientific record which can be verified and which can ensure transparency and universal validity. It means we can compare them and we can also follow them across the world so that various parties feel satisfied and they can have understanding of a simple single body of knowledge. They need not to learn different accounting standard, different accounting principles to be followed differently by different countries. So we are having a standard body of knowledge which is to be followed by all the practitioners across the globe. Then we are coming to talk about the objectives of bookkeeping. It's just to maintain a systematic and classified record. That means journaling and ledgers are part of bookkeeping, whereas we're talking about accounting. Extend help to all related parties which are having stake or interest in the operations of a business entity. It means the method or mode of ensuring transparency in the operations of a business entity or non-business entity is the objective of accounting. Here we are having last basic difference, nature of job. The people who gain knowledge about the body or systematic body of knowledge having principles, concepts, formats, etc. must bear scientific attitude in themselves. It means we are going to learn about set of principles, concepts, be they are conventions, which are applicable across the globe universally. That means they are generally accepted. Here we are saying that this task is more or less is of clerical nature. That means we have to just perform paperwork, but intellectual part is being performed when we become accountant. It means when we move ahead from the recording and classification of transaction, here we have to apply our experience, we have to apply our ability, we have to apply our skill, and we have to show that how better understanding we are having about the environment in our surrounding, how better predictions and planning we can make on the basis of this analysis, and how effectively and in easy form we can serve that information to all those who are having stake in the operations of our business entity. This is all about this single difference. In your book you might find two different tables having difference between accounting and accountancy and bookkeeping, and then another table accountancy and accounting. Instead, these are six basic differences which you can follow. Whether they ask you to differentiate between accountancy and accounting or accounting and bookkeeping. So the single difference you can follow, it will be more productive to you. If you like this video, you should subscribe, share and comment to us so that we can improve our skills and better delivery can ensure to you in the next lecture. Thank you very much for listening to us. Have a good time, good day. Stay safe, stay home.